like that they're able to get a chance. I mean, it looks like Team Insidious are just completely rolling over Team True Rippers. And True Rippers, left, right, and center, just getting slaughtered here. It's an absolute massacre as Insidious up to 25 points now. And now finally it seems that True Rippers will be able to get 5 of their members up and running, get 2 picks. But once again, look at the time of Chris. I mean, by the time they got these picks, it's almost time for the second hard point.
Yeah, luckily the second hard point is also very close by, so them holding on to Heaven actually might just help him out for the second hard point as well. True Rippers now, they've been sent back to their spawns. Blood, he's trying to lurk around the corner, making sure that the players of Team IND don't clump up together and form a big wave, but he's only gonna get one kill. The rest of Team IND players still having Heaven control. Luckily, they're not down on the hard point just yet, but they're still getting all the points, so they don't even need to have all their players. Just one is enough, and oh my god, look at that barrage of kills coming in. They've sent back the second wave of True Rippers as well. Now, True Rippers ko ek saath aane ke liye thoda time lagega, which will give Insidious another few bunch of points.
Yeah, I mean, time and time again, aisa lag raha hai ki True Rippers are just not able to gather up their forces, and uski wajah se they're never able to contest the hard point in full force. I mean, hum dekh sakte ki abhi yahan pe there are 3 players starting to walk in towards, lekin wo ek ek karke contact le rahe hain, and as a result, they end up giving these 1v1s. The final fight becomes a 3v1 for the last surviving player, and you don't get control over the hard point. And seriously, abhi bhi ye hard point pe ekdam kadak jama ke rakha hai apna pair, and it doesn't look like Team True Rippers are going to be able to get control of this hard point anytime soon. But with that said, they did get control for a second or two. It was instantly reclaimed by Insidious though, so it's not going to be a lot of points. They're going to get 16 on this one, and before moving on to the next, this one should be fairly interesting. A bit more open of an area to work with, so maybe there's more opportunity. Thanks, a lot more trophy systems and Doha gas grenades are required to control this one, so we'll see if they're able to actually make this work. The equal,
they go for something a little more mellow, a little more slow. It does seem to be a little slow this time. Ooh, he almost died over there. There was so much damage dealt with that nade, but he somehow survived, and Born to Kill also capitalizes on that. Spots out the player inside the wooden building. He might just catch this one as well. Oh, he missed. Yeah, no problem though. He's done his job. He's got the information. That player transitioned back over towards Zeylong, so he probably might be bamboozled by the fact that he saw him cross towards wood. But hopefully he will find some information to work with again.
Yes, 7C, they are going to lose one of their players. Greedy is going to be taken out, and this is going to open things up on B. All 4 members rushing in. Remember, the side of 7C is still very, very susceptible to this, and Unholy is going to find the kill on Smokey, and this is going to open the side up for the side of Team MMX Esports. They're going to find the second kill as well, and there you go. The retake is going to come in from Zeegan, but in a 2v4 situation, this is not the easiest retake in the world. If he spots out the leg of the player planting the bomb, maybe he can make this a little bit easier for himself, but no, he's a little bit afraid and the timing is off. Yeah, 7C just Born to Kill and Zeegan remaining, and we'll see what they decide to do. I like what Zeegan's doing. He's instead just gonna go towards where Born to Kill is, maybe go and start things off, you know, bait them to peek out, and then the sniper can get a kill. But yeah, it's gonna be difficult, and Zeegan is gonna find a kill on Zilla. Freddy's gonna trade him out real quick. A 1v3 situation. 14 seconds remaining on the clock. Born to Kill is gonna find one, gonna find two. Can he find the third one and make this happen? That's the question. Not a lot of time remaining on the clock. 8 seconds, the bomb is gonna be tapped. The peak is gonna come through. He slides and he prevents the bomb from being defused. I don't think there's enough time remaining. That's gonna be the end of the round. MMX walk away with the token. A bit of a slip up here by Unite Esports, but there's always another round to reset and gather your thoughts and feelings once again. This time around though, Wolfpack switching things up. I see multiple players pushing up towards B, trying to get some control over there. But they're still hoping to find that initial pick that's going to make life easier for them. And that's towards A. I see two players pushed up there. One of them being the sniper, the other one with the bomb. And yeah, so far, they're just trying to feel out what defense United Esports have put up. It's a bit of a unique one. 3 players playing towards that B area, 1 towards mid. But once again, Skyosh opening things up by finding that headshot on XC through the wall, and now Boopsy is going to continue holding towards B, going to drop that smoke grenade, hopefully set up some smoke and mirrors for the side of Team Wolfpack to maybe find an open A site. The answer is going to be no. Bhagwan is going to be able to find Hammy Zam on the site, and Rhythm is the only one still surviving over there. He's in the trailer, he's going to be able to find one kill. Can he find the second one and prevent the plant? No, he cannot. The plant is still going to go down, and now Rhythm, he's gonna start moving back in over there. Obvious, gonna jump. I mean, he's crouching and going back up to just try and get the kill on the planter, but he's unable to do so. And look at that, Boobsy and Mercy finding their own individual kills, making it a 3v1. And now Rhythm, he's just gonna get surrounded from all.
Have the sanity anymore, but Wolfpack seem to have their wits about them. Oh my god!
Oh my god!
Disgusting!
I didn't even see that. I didn't even see the flick register on my screen. That's how quick it was. That was absolutely nutty coming in from Skyos. And that's going to open things up towards A. I'm going to clear out Trailer with the help of that grenade, but it's actually going to pulse back towards him. Yeah. A bit of a whoopsie there, but thankfully he still has a sniper rifle to just sort of cover both the areas. The player inside Trailer is taking a lot of damage, and now the RPG is going to come in to finish him off. He sees a trophy system inside though, so he's going to wise out and not really use that rocket launcher for now. Just going to keep his eyes towards Armory, but he also has to worry about backstab. Wolfpack, where is the rest of their team? I don't see where the members are. Despa's actually getting a big backstab, but finally Skyos will be able to take him out, and there you go. Two players were actually lurking towards the mid area. That's why the backstab was open for the side of Team Wolfpack.
Jesus. Wolfpack never even needed to go towards the B side. They work mid.
Yep.
They hold for a bit. And then they brute force their way into the A side. But oh my god, okay, Unite Esports changing up the pace this time. They're the ones who take the fights towards Wolfpack. They rush out mid. Hamzy with a double. Weed gets one kill of his own. And somehow, Unite Esports are winning these fights. They take the aggression up a notch and they rush the wooden building, but Skyos greets him with an SMRS. Somehow, Wolfpack survived that initial skirmish. That change of pace definitely caught them off guard, but it's back down to a 2v2 now. Wolfpack realized that the mid area should be relatively empty right now that the push has come through. United Esports members fall back towards Trader and A. And Wolfpack read it like a book. They have control of the B site. They should be able to plant the bomb.
Yeah, I mean, no one from United Esports really on the site now. Just only now they're starting to realize that the plant is probably coming in towards B. And there you go, Despa getting a little bit too desperate, like his name implies, and it's going to be taken down. Weed, the only person surviving, the Karma member of the team. Let's see what he can do over here. If he can tap into that Zen mode and find those two kills. Starting to go in from the defender spawn side, throwing that grenade to clear out containers, but it's not going to do much. Both players playing site, holding a bit of a crossfire over there, and there you go. All the way towards B and get the bomb down. Objective-based gaming at its finest. But the bomb is actually not under his control. Oh no, the bomb is all the way towards A. And now it seems that Initiative Zyme have flanked all the way around and are coming in from towards B. And F5 Bunny should be able to pick that up. He's a little bit hesitant. He doesn't know where the enemy team is. And he's trying to check every single corner, every single angle, do his due diligence. But yeah, there's only so much he can do. Well, he's going to pick the bomb up and start making his way back towards that B site. And there you go, Zesty. Peeks him, gets the kill. It's going to be the end of that round, Initiative Zyme. Making short work of that round. I'm pretty sure that last surviving member of F5 Esports is pretty confused as to what the hell just happened.
Yeah, I was actually worried that Initiative Zyme leaving the bomb and opting to chase him would actually result in their loss, but they double peek him nonetheless, and F5 Esports really couldn't do much. Even this time, they have one trade, but FI Bunny getting into Armory might just spell doom for them. Luckily, Kashish will be taken down by Zesty, but he's getting peaked, and F5 Esports overextending. Somehow, they don't go punished. Sundance is still over here, but he hasn't spotted anyone just yet, and Automatic is hiding under the chest. Now, this is a very cheeky spot. Sundance might not see this. He's done plenty of damage. Automatic is going to fall back, try to go to the side, but look at the bomb. It's dropped on mid, and Initiative Zyme have control of it.
Yep. And it seems that Automatic is caught between a rock and a hard place, trying to worry about his backstab while also trying to take out the player on the opposite side, guarding the entrance to Armory. And he's in a bit of a tough spot. I mean, if that player just plays with discipline, just never peeks, then there's nothing much you can do if you're on the side of F5. It's kind of just all boils down to Spectra's shoulders and how much he can lift. Deed is actually going to turn around with the Bison though and take him out.